Hey guys, I haven't talked to you in like a whole day. It probably won't feel like a whole day to you, but today we are heading to Beijing. I'm going to the Great Wall in the next few days, so we're heading there first. We're going on a bullet train, and it does I think something like 300 miles an hour, so it's gonna take us 6 hours to travel 2,000 miles or something like that. I can't exactly remember the full maths of it all, but that's where we're going now. We're leaving this little town. I finally found out what the name of this little town is. It translates to Hawaiian town, and I think the issue with the whole town is like the way it was really abandoned and stuff. There was like a big building thing going on here, and it was to be finished in 2015, and it never got finished. So it's obviously now 2018 and it's still not done. And I think what ended up happening was factories started opening and the whole place just went bust basically. But it's so weird, like everything like near the town just looks completely and utterly abandoned. And yesterday I got my nails taken off. You probably can't even see that, I don't know, but I got them taken off. They're really short now. Look how short they are. They're really, really, really short now. They're my natural nails and my natural length. I was like not able to maintain the gel nails. They were getting chipped and they looked awful, so I just said I'd go with the short nails for now. And I'm pretty happy with them. I got like really cute like glitter and like nude nails. I don't know. Yeah, they're really cute anyway. So that's the story with the little town here. And I really liked it because I love like looking at abandoned stuff. I don't know, I'm really weird like that. Our train is leaving at 5, so we're leaving the hotel here at 2, I think, because it takes an hour to get to the train station. They always recommend to be at the train station an hour and a half before your train actually leaves. Train stations here are insanely mental. I think I mentioned that the last time. They're just nuts, like the amount of people that does be in them. All the trains are always booked up, and because this is such like a short travel, we're not going on like a sleeper train or anything like that. Those sleeper trains are great, like they're really, really like handy if you want to do an overnight, you know, train journey and like you're not wasting the whole day in a train. But because this journey is really short and we kind of just want to be in Beijing for nights so then we can sleep and then like start fresh, because you do not really get that great quality of sleep on like sleeper trains and sleeper buses. It just doesn't happen. And definitely not if you're me, because I'm too, I don't know, I'm really weird like about like sleeping places that I'm unfamiliar with. Like even when I'm sleeping in a hotel, like oh my god, this is going to sound pathetic, but like I always like make sure that the mattress and the bed sheets are kind of like clean or have been cleaned, and that I know that they're fresh and stuff. Whereas on sleeper trains and sleeper buses, like it's highly unlikely that they've been cleaned in weeks. So the little place that we're staying in, where we stayed in the last two nights, it was two nights or three nights we've stayed here. It's a lovely little hotel, but I think it's like a family owned hotel or family owned like B&B type thing, but it's like someone's home. It's really, really cute and quaint and stuff, and you know, it's nice. Like there's like a family here, the two little girls, they're so adorable, and there's like a bakery near here and stuff. I'm just really liking the little town. Like, so Hawaiian town I think is what it's called. In this area of Shanghai there's like tons and tons, or not this area of Shanghai, it's called Feng Shui. Oh my god, went to Punong. That was where Disneyland was, but this other place is called like Feng something or other, and I just can't pronounce anything. But this area has like loads of little towns. It's like a county, like if you're in Ireland, like it's much larger. Like the whole of Shanghai is like four times the size of Ireland, like that'll just tell you. So the area that we're staying in is like a little county, and then has like loads of little towns. So I suppose like if you're staying in like County Louth, and there's loads of little towns in it, or if you're staying in like County Donegal, and there's loads of little towns in it. So where we're staying, this part of Shanghai, being a city, there's like a little county that we're kind of staying in, and we're staying in a little town of that county. Like it's just bizarre because it's just such an insanely massive country. China is just like crazy massive. Yeah, I'll catch up with you guys later on. So this is Natural Island. I wonder when this is supposed to be finished. March. Yeah, it's coming along quite well.
Yeah. empty apartment buildings, probably cost millions to make, and nobody's ever going to live in them.
I love this little bar, it's my favourite bar. This is it here. It's such a cute little bar. This is what it's called. It's the nicest place around. It's so cute. No old telephone and stuff. And then they can sit outside, which is where I'm going to sit, and there's an egg chair out there, which I'm going to sit in. It's just so cute. There's a little waterfall over there. I love all like the stuff. It's just such a cute little pub. I love it.
This is the bullet train that we're going on. It's so fast and travels at 300 kilometers an hour. So much better than the standard trains. Because it's just gonna be ridiculously quick. 11. We're in here.
Okay. So we're in 10. 10A. Oh, in here. 10A and B.
欢迎您乘坐高铁动车组列车，我代表动车组全体乘务人员向您问好，祝您旅行愉快。列车运行前方到站是昆山南站。
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the high-speed EMU train. We extend to you our warm welcome and wish you a pleasant trip. The next stop is Kunshanlan Railway Station.
Beijing. I can't believe I'm actually saying that. Like, it's been something that I've wanted to do for so long, and I'm finally in Beijing. So the story is that we are going to be going to the Great Wall tomorrow. I think we're going to try and stay near the Great Wall. I don't know what the story is. I just got myself a Starbucks. It's breakfast time here, and unless you want noodles, which I'm kind of accustomed to now in China, you're not getting fed. So what I'm doing today is we're going to hang around Beijing because it's absolutely beautiful. So inner city is all like full of ancient kind of like ruin, not ruins, but like ancient kind of buildings, like lovely like lanterns, little knickety-knack streets, like there's just stuff everywhere to see. It's just absolutely beautiful. And we're just going to be doing that for the entire day, and then go off to the Great Wall tomorrow and spend the day out there, try and get staying near the Great Wall, because they're all like kind of organized like trips, which is really annoying because it's like a day trip here, there and everywhere, and I don't want to do a day trip. We want to kind of like spend the entire day there, because there is all parts of the Great Wall, obviously, because it's like what, 13,000 miles long, so there's like really old parts of the Great Wall that people don't generally go to. I want to go there and see ruins because I'm obsessed with ruins. Yeah, so that's the whole plan for the next couple of days. We only have 6 days left in Beijing and then it's back to Erlangen, which I am kind of sad about because I've just really enjoyed my time actually in China. It took me about 5-6 days to get used to it. I remember when I first arrived here when I was in Guangzhou, I was like, oh my god, I hate China, I'm never gonna get used to it, you know. You know, the people aren't nice, I hate the food. Whereas now I'm here, what, 3 weeks and I love it. Like, I'm so used to the food, I'm so used to the people, how abrupt they are, you know. The fact that everybody looks at you and laughs at you, and I'm just used to it now and I don't care anymore. Like, I just think it's just so much fun here. I absolutely love China now and I'm just loving the cultural difference and the fact that I am just, you know, I'm just really enjoying it. So, sorry, it's getting really annoying. Here. I'm gonna take you around Beijing today. I don't know how much talking I'm gonna actually do today because I'm gonna try and show you some of the sites. I've already kind of explored a little bit of Beijing. It's such a beautiful city, way better than Shanghai. I didn't actually go into the in-depth of Shanghai because it's such a new city. I'm just not interested in it. Whereas this is like, when I think of China, this is what I think of. So I'll show you around later. It's getting super noisy, but I'll talk to you then. down outside McDonald's after getting like ice creams and stuff and like exploring. I love how we come to like Beijing and I'm sitting outside a McDonald's. I explored a lot today, got to see like loads of the markets. I got some souvenirs for home. I got some magnets for the fridge. I managed to get my mom something for her dresser. And then we got like this dessert, like this really cool thing. It looks like an airboard with ice cream in it, but it was like wafer. It was just amazing. They just went to get something to eat, kind of wandered around Beijing. It's mahoose up here. Like, you'll never see the whole of Beijing. We have our trip planned for tomorrow to the Great Wall. I'm gonna stay out in a place called, oh, hang on now. An area outside the Great Wall or near the Great Wall, one part of it that we're going to, obviously near Beijing. So we're either going to stay like on a farm or a hotel. I'm not really sure yet what the story is because we have to get out there and see, but there's loads of hotels out there. I'm really excited because the farm looks really cool because it's like looking, overlooking water as well. So I guess we'll know more when we get out there. It's such a fab day. The weather is incredible. Very overcast, not overcast, it's a smog again, like, but it's not as bad as Guangzhou or somewhere else. It was really bad. Shanghai, it was pretty bad as well. And Yiwu, it was bad as well. I just feel like smog is just kind of taking over the whole place. But definitely Beijing, it's not too bad where we are in the old quarter. I'm sure if I went into the new quarter, it'd be pretty bad. I'm just loving it here right now. It reminds me of when I was in Vietnam, just been in Beijing here today, because it's just like the markets and it's just, I don't know, it's really authentic. It's real China. That's what I think of when I think of China, and I love it here. So yeah, I'm really happy out. I'm in my element, so I am. I don't know what else to say to you guys other than Great Wall tomorrow. I am super excited. I just, you know when you hear things about China, the Great Wall is the first thing that pops into your head, and I'm actually going to be there. And to think that I traveled like almost like 4,000 miles across the whole of China is ridiculous. Like, I've traveled on land from Vietnam all the way up to Beijing on like trains and buses. It's crazy, and I feel like for my first real traveling experience, I'm pretty proud of myself. Now, I didn't actually think I'd be able to do it, but I did it and achieved it. I'm just being really proud of myself. I know that's probably really ridiculous to anybody who's watching this vlog and they're like, I've traveled for so long and I've traveled to loads of different places, but for me, this is a brand new experience. Never ever done it before, and I'm seeing amazing people and new cultures.
It is really pretty, isn't it?
No.
Can we go in?
We're staying. I just thought I'd show you like what it looks like. I'm kind of whispering because obviously people are asleep, but it's so amazing. Little lanterns all along here. These are like people's bedrooms, but it's just so cute. I thought I'd show you at night because it looks prettier. But like, this is it. Like, it's all like rooms all around there, and then like a little courtyard here. It's really, really, really old. Like, super old. I'd say it's hundreds of years old. There's like a balcony up there. It's so pretty. Our room was really, really old. Like, there's no mod cons or anything like that. I really like it. Like, that's unreal. And the wall and stuff. And we've got the steps downstairs, obviously. And this is like where they do the laundry. And down here is like more rooms. There's a map of the world there. Not to scale, we were looking at it earlier, it doesn't look to scale, but there's like more bedrooms in here. It's fab. And obviously that's upstairs where it was. It's just really nice. So look at the old doors, and they've got like more rooms down there in this little courtyard area. Super, super cute and old fashioned. We were looking at this earlier as well. They have kind of like spears along here. Like, it's just really, really nice. And all of this is like open.
Like it's all like the night air is coming in through here, but it's locked up in there. It's just so pretty, really authentic. I've never seen anything like it before. And then my room is down here. So I am in room number 816. This is what my bed looks like. So it's just in here, like in a little cubby. It's really, really, really random. There's not a whole lot of room for things. So like my bag is on the floor. There's stuff everywhere. And then we have the bathroom here with a shower. Look how pretty the sink is. It's super pretty. It's all floral. I love it. And then you've got this shutter here for privacy, obviously. Looks like that. So yeah, that's me done for the night. I'm going to the Great Wall first thing in the morning. And I'm so tired already because I had a very busy day traveling yesterday on the the bullet train. I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. We went to this really cool bar tonight and I got my laundry done. Packing up a bag. I'm bringing like a day bag with me tomorrow to the Great Wall. And yeah, I'm super excited. So yeah, I'm going to hop into bed now, have an early night, get up at 6:30 in the morning, off to the Great Wall, and I'm just excited to see what the Great Wall holds. I'm not wearing makeup at all anymore. Like, I just don't bother with it, except for concealer, mascara, and brow products. That's it. I just don't care about makeup at all out here. Anyway, guys, I will talk to you in the AM.